and welcome to Triamec. I'm happy to introduce our 100 kHz servo drive, which is ultra precise, ultra transparent, and ultra programmable.
This is one of our newest features. This is the so-called pulsing unit. With the pulsing unit, you're able to pulse your laser or any other device at a very high frequency of up to 10 MHz. It works with a so-called FIFO unit, meaning that you can save your pulsing sequence in advance and then it gets fired automatically based on your encoder position. This gives you maximum freedom, also together with our freely programmable timer programs, as you've just seen for the pendulum. Here on the screen, we see again the pulsing units that I explained before. As you can see here, the pulsing can really happen at free floating positions up to 64-bit resolutions on the encoder signal itself. Here we see in red the sine amplitude and in yellow the triggering. Here we show different binary positions and you can also see it all happens at 2 MHz. So we are really, really fast with this triggering.
And now it's spinning at 1 Hz and it's going up 10 times every time. It has 6 pole pairs, so you see the commutation frequency is 6 times higher than the mechanical speed. And we'll drive it up now to 6000 Hz, which with a 1 pole pair motors, like a high-speed spindle for PCB drilling, that corresponds to 360,000 RPM.
Here we have a standard CNC axis, which is used in series machines. Here on the screen you can see we do first millimeter moves, then in the next section we do micrometer moves. You can see here in green the set point and also the actual position. And finally we do nanometer moves. And you can see that we still are able to resolve the position, and if I touch the board you can see the disturbance.
The pendulum will speed up in circles while balancing the rod. The code for this is all inside here. It's written in C# because there's a virtual machine capable of running .NET languages in real time. That means every 10 or with a frequency of 10 kHz, this code will be executed to make this pendulum motion. No additional computer necessary, only for the programming. As you can see, there is also disturbance rejection and the pendulum is able to handle any disturbances.
Here we show an example for impulse decoupling. This means the stator of the linear motor is not fixed, but movable and also controlled by a servo axis. With this, the impulse of the movement of the axis is not transferred to the base and does not generate excitation of the base. Here we see the machine with fixed stator. So you see no movement of the stator, and in this case we have a huge excitement of the base. In contrast with the impulse decoupling, the stator is moving and we have nearly no excitement of the base. We provide power up to 38 kilowatt. Our smallest servo drive is for 80 volt DC voltage and provides 10 ampere RMS current and 20 ampere peak current. Here you can see the interfaces to the servo drive. First, we have 2 encoder inputs, which can be extended with 2 additional option modules, for example, for additional encoder inputs for dual loop, or also for additional analog input and outputs. Then here we have the motor connectors for 2 motors, and also digital input and outputs. Either CAT or the TriaLink bus can be connected to these connectors. And then we have also Ethernet connection and USB connection for commissioning and monitoring of the servo drive.
Thanks for watching. We're looking forward to seeing you next year here at SPS. If you have further questions or you need further information, visit us at triamec.com. Visit our YouTube channel, and we're also on GitHub. If you need some free code examples, just check it out and contact us if you have any further questions. Thank you.